Hello and welcome to St. Mary's Now, a partnership between the Enterprise newspaper and the Forrest Center TV video production program. I'm Katrina Walcott.
And I'm Louis Bose. And here's the latest news from the Enterprise.
According to data from the U.S. Census Bureau, St. Mary's County population growth significantly slowed last year. The population only increased by 0.2%, which gave a total population of 112,664 people. That number puts St. Mary's County into a tie as the 15th fastest growing county in Maryland. The county has always been ranked in the top fastest growing counties from year to year. Chris Kasalmis, director of the St. Mary's Department of Economic Development, said, "We are a growing county and we have been for years. I don't expect that aspect to change."
Beginning September 1st, smoking, vaping, and all other uses of tobacco will be prohibited at St. Mary's parks and museums, excluding Wicomico Shores Golf Course. After a vote on Tuesday, starting January 1st, 2020, the use of nicotine products will be prohibited on county property for county employees and visitors. Last June, the commissioners approved establishing tobacco-free goals after county employee surveys indicated an increase in interest in transitioning to a tobacco-free environment.
The St. Mary's County Commissioners on Tuesday moved $1.35 million from a reserve account to pay for the cleanup costs of the 2018-2019 winter season's four snow events and flooding from Hurricane Florence. The Commissioners' emergency reserve balance will be almost $335,000 after realigning the budget. The county fiscal staff periodically realigns money from county government vacancies to add to the reserve accounts, but as they tighten up and take care of employees with the compensation increases, they will probably have less vacancies in the future.
Tuesday morning, school bus drivers stood on the corner next to Benjamin Banneker Elementary School in Loveville with cardboard signs reading "Higher pay for bus drivers" and "Lowest paid county bus drivers in Maryland." The bus driver stated that they chose that location because the school system's Department of Supporting Services, which housed the transportation department, is located behind the school. Five St. Mary's County Public School bus drivers who are contracted with Kessler Bus Services did not drive their school buses Tuesday morning in protest of the low-paying salaries. Six more drivers and aides joined them after they finished their routes that morning.
Even though school may not have been in session on Monday at Choptacon High School, the softball field was heated with tough competition. Two unbeaten softball teams, the Choptacon Braves and the Huntingtown Hurricanes, faced off and ended in a 3-0 shutout in the Braves' favor. Hurricanes head coach Mike Johnson said, "This was a tough loss against a very good team. You have to give Choptacon all the credit in the world."
The Southern Maryland Blue Crabs will be kicking off their 2019 season on the road against the Sugarland Skeeters. The Blue Crabs will begin the season with a number of returning players. Daryl Thompson, a baseball player and graduate of La Plata High School in 2003, will be Blue Crabs' pitching coach in addition to being on the five-man starting rotation. "When I was in high school, the Blue Crabs didn't exist. The stadium wasn't here. Honestly, I don't know what I would be doing if the team wasn't here," Thompson said. "I knew that I always wanted to get into coaching, but I've always thought of myself as a player now and a coach later," said Thompson. Hitting coach Craig Maddox has been a player slash coach for several seasons and will assume both roles for this Blue Crabs season as well.
This news brief has been provided by The Enterprise. For more details, visit somdnews.com. That's all we have for you on this edition of St. Mary's Now. I'm Katrina Walcott.
And I'm Louis Bose.
Signing off.